Fathers of Reddit, in honor of Father's Day, what was your don't tell your mother about this moment? Not a father, but I have a wholesome story of my own dad. I was born very early, at only 4 pounds. On top of that, or possibly as a result, I have a fragile immune system, especially so when I was young, and up until a few years ago, I got seriously sick. Fever, vomiting, sore throat, the whole shebang. 5 times or more a year. I would become so dehydrated from vomiting or get such a high fever that at times, I had to be brought into the emergency room. As a result, I drank exclusively Pedialyte to counter that when sick, and I developed a serious distaste and hate for the stuff. My dad was responsible for bathing me one night to help me cool down. I must have been 6 or 7 at the oldest. We were on a vacation, and even as an adult, I always get really sick during or after traveling. And I had inconveniently gotten sick while we were staying in a hotel. I'd had a high fever, and my body was so sore and tired I'd slept for 24 hours. No one could wake me up, and I hadn't drank anything in that time. So my dad put in front of me a very big glass of Pedialyte and told me I had to finish the whole thing while I sat in the bath. I took it as obediently as I could, but a fourth of the way in, I just felt so miserable and mad that I started sobbing. My dad had this heartbreaking look on his face, and stroked my hair, near tears himself. It was late, and we were tired, so he wrapped me up in a towel, and put me in bed with he and mom. My dad drinks a lot of Mountain Dew, and he told me that for every 3 sips of Pedialyte I get down, I can have a sip of soda to help wash out the bad taste. But don't tell mom. I never did, and it's one of my favorite memories of me and my dad. Oh, that was so heartbreaking, but a wonderful ending. He sounds like an amazing father. While building the outdoor play set for my 5-year-old, I drilled a screw completely through a board and into my shoe, barely stopping just as the screw broke skin. I swore right in front of him, something along the lines of mother freaking frick mother sucker. We are sworn to secrecy to this day. Almost screwed yourself there, bud. My dad has passed away, so I'll tell this on his behalf. My sister was maybe 10 or 11. My dad was very worried and had been waiting all day for us to come home from school. When we got home, he pulled her aside saying he needed to have a serious talk with her. He said to her, "I was looking for a pencil and found this in your desk," and pulled out a plastic baggie filled with some dried plant material. She said, "Oh, catnip." He thought it was pot. We would make little cat toys with catnip, and the bag had ripped, so she put it in a Ziploc bag. He sighed a huge sigh of relief and laughed and told her he thought she was doing drugs and asked her not to tell our mom. He was so embarrassed. Hey, in fairness to him, if you're worried, it's better to communicate openly about it than it is to sit and stew on it. By addressing the concern directly, he got to know there's nothing to worry about, and all it cost him was a bit of dignity. Saying this in honor of my dad, as he is very old and does not read it. He once cut the end of my toe off as a baby, cutting my sharp baby nails, and my screaming brought in my brother. Hey joined forces to get me all bandaged up and told my mother I'd banged it into a wall or trapped it in a door or something. My mum found out, and by extension so did I, when I was 10. A wholesome one. For my mum's 50th birthday, he bought her a set of vintage diamond and pearl earrings and a necklace. I helped him choose them out. I'm never allowed to tell her just how much they cost. My son randomly walked to the kitchen, 3 a.m, was finishing up some Call of Duty, and he saw me eating ice cream. So I got him a bowl and we were whispering like nerds. He was 4, and I said don't tell mom, and he said don't tell mom. Didn't do the dishes following morning, and my wife asked who had ice cream. Son of a bee pointed right at me, lol. This last Christmas, my 4-year-old helped my wife wrap one of my gifts. It was late, so I was working. The next day, while my wife was at work, she came running through from her bedroom first thing and yelled excitedly, "Daddy, Daddy, I helped wrap your gift. It's a surprise. It's a slushy maker. Honey, that's awesome, but you aren't supposed to tell me that." I know, but it's a slushy maker. If you know not to tell me, then why did you tell me?" "Because I'm just so excited to make slushies with you." I was crying with laughter at this point and told her that it's an awesome gift, but to keep gifts secret, and I told her we wouldn't tell mommy so she wouldn't be disappointed that I knew what it was. I ended up telling her that evening because it was just too funny and cute. My little cousin was wrapping a Christmas present for her dad with her mum. It was a watch. She asked if it was a surprise and her mum said yes. So she saw her dad later and she said, "Daddy, we got you a present. It's not a watch." I guess to her that was the best form of misdirection she could think of. Not a father, but I was with my dad and we thought it was a good idea to start a small fire on the porch, the wooden porch. It was made of mostly paper and we made sure to scatter the embers and everything, but after we went inside and to bed, the wind must have kicked up because we came outside the next day and there was a giant hole burned into the porch. My dad just told me, "Hey, don't tell your mom, I'll get it fixed." He then proceeded to cover it with a small table. She found out anyway and we're pretty lucky that the house didn't burn down. I would like to clarify if the house would have burned down because of the fire or the mother. Dad and I used to rent a movie each week for when mum had dinner with friends, usually things like Star Trek or action films. One day, I was about 11. He came home with Blade. We got about 10 minutes in and he turns to me and said, "Don't tell your mother about this. Let's just say I forgot to get it this week." Of course I agree. Fast forward 7-ish years. Dad blithely drops at the dinner table the fact that we watched Blade when I was about 11. Silly dad thought there was some kind of statute of limitations on this. For my dad and I, it was cop movies like Last Boy Scout, Lethal Weapon, Die Hard, etc. At the time my mom lost her crap when she found out I was fond of those kind of TV movies, cause I'd already seen the theatrical versions of Mayo. Not a real don't tell your mother about this moment, but when I was little, my dad had a workshop in the garage where he'd do woodwork. I'd come out and talk to him while he worked, and he'd let me sit on the car that was parked in the garage. He framed it as something that was so bad and edgy and we couldn't tell my mom, and I was 5, so I believed it and felt so cool without actually doing anything wrong or dangerous. He just sitting there, menacingly. My dad, brother, and I went out to these dunes near where I live with bottle rockets. We each had an empty milk jug and each took like 20 bottle rockets for ammo. Then, we ran around launching bottle rockets at each other. I was the youngest, which made me the hardest to hit, so I won the rocket war. But yeah, mom never found out. Your hitbox needed to be nerfed. In my second year of college, my best friend committed suicide. We were all pretty heartbroken, so my mom and dad drove up from the next province to be with me. My dad, being a great cook, decided he would cook my roommate's friends and I a nice dinner to bring everyone together during the bleak moment. My dad and I ended up getting completely s-faced, as one tends to do during heartbreaking times. He got embarrassed at his drunken state and snuck out the back door and jumped in a cab without saying goodbye. I was upset he disappeared like that, but he also still had the car keys I needed so I could drive my friends and I to the funeral the next day. I called him and asked him to get out of the cab and that I would meet him at whatever street corner he was at, which he did. When I found him, he was sitting in the stoop of an apartment building puking and crying. I rolled up and together we staggered home drunk and crying arm in arm. When we got back to my apartment, he was still embarrassed, so he asked to sleep in the car. I said okay, grabbed him a blanket, Pringles and a Gatorade for midnight munchies. I go back inside and no sooner did I sit down did I get a text from him saying he was cold and wanted to come in. I went and got him from the car and he was covered in Pringle crumbs. Like, covered. I dragged him up the sketchy spiral staircase to my apartment and the last thing he said before he went inside and to bed was, "God, your stairs are like frickin' Hogwarts, man. Please don't tell your mother." And he passed out. It was the moment I saw my dad as a real person, not just my father. I think a lot of fathers try to be strong and stoic for their kids during hard times, in an attempt to be stable for us. Sharing this heartbreaking moment with him just brought us closer together. I love my dad. Man cooks a mean bavette steak. Good man. Good man. Not a father but a son. We forgot my passport during vacation and were already at the border station when we noticed. My dad then said that we won't turn back but that he will figure something out. Turns out he smuggled me successfully across 3 border crossings without my passport. Before we arrived at home, he told me not to tell my mom about this. daughter speaking for her father. In high school, everybody was always busy at work or clubs, so I was the first one in my household to get home nearly every single day. Dad was having money troubles that he didn't want to disclose to anyone, so he paid me $5 a month to take the bank statement letter from the mailbox and hide it from my stepmom until he got home. It was the closest thing I got to an allowance. P.S. I had no idea what the money trouble was. BTW. I was always the don't ask, don't tell person, so that's why he trusted me the most about this. Clearly all this bribery was causing him money problems. Not a father but a story about mine. One day I decided to pull a sick day at school and came downstairs and saw that my dad was making a coffee. I asked him what he was doing and why he wasn't at work, and he said I could ask you the same question. We stood in silence for a moment and he said I won't tell your mum if you won't. We had a good laugh about it and he let me have the day off. One night when I was about 8, after I had gone to bed, my dad was playing a Nintendo game. Legend of Zelda, I think. We had both been playing it but we were stuck. He finally found a secret passage, paused the game, and came upstairs to wake me up. He told me he figured out where we were stuck, snuck me downstairs in a blanket. I'm sure my mom knew, and I got to stay up after midnight on a school night, hiding under a blanket, to see where the hidden passage went. It was a silly little incident, but very memorable. Anyone interested about my relationship with my dad? We actually weren't that close, and still aren't, because reasons. But this story stands out in my memory not just because it was awesome and wholesome, because it wasn't like him. As to the specifics of the game secret passage, after some googling, I can't find a Zelda-related secret that matches my memory. I recall a path that is going east then turns south. To the right there's an ocean, and if you just keep going east instead of turning south, there's a hidden pathway you can walk over the ocean. We played several similar games with that old top-down view. Could have been Dragon Warrior, Eight Eyes, or so many others. Maybe someone on here can figure it out. Thanks to the Hive Mind for figuring out it was Zelda 2. When you get the water boots and can walk over the water to get to the Ocean Palace. It's great to fill in the gaps of a nice childhood memory. This is so sweet. I can't stop smiling at the imagery you've given me. This is so cool. I love this. It was my weekend with my 15-year-old son. We had divorced when he was 10. We were at a pool party barbecue at my friend's condo complex and I had brought a couple sodas for him. The dude cooking the chicken overcooked it and was dry. And another friend had pilfered one of the Dr. Peppers, so my son needed something to drink. I suggested he go back to the condo and find something in the fridge. Then he pointed at the plastic pitcher with about a glass left of margarita. I said okay, but don't tell your mom. I figured he would just take a mouthful to wash down the food, but nope. He pounded the whole thing. I was like okay. Well, there wasn't that much in there, so no biggie. I said dang dude, didn't think you were gonna chug the whole thing. He was like what? Is there alcohol in it? I was like yeah dude, it's a margarita. He said but you guys used to make us kids margaritas when you had people over the house. I said yeah. Virgin ones with just ice and the mixer in the blender. Not the adult version with tequila in it. Well, next thing you know he's super chatty. Actually talking to all my friends like a normal outgoing person instead of his usual teenage introverted small talk. Problem was it was Sunday and I had to take him back to his mom's that evening. I was planning on getting bitched out about it. Or she would find it hilarious. Honestly, it could have gone either way with her. I could never predict how she would take it. Luckily she was out when we got there and I told him to just go to his room and take a nap. He already fell asleep in the car on the way there. She was none the wiser. I think sometime later he eventually told her about it and she did find it funny after all. He played you like a champ. When my wife's at work, I will take my daughter, 4-year-old, out for breakfast. Then we will go on a small adventure around a shop of her choice and pretend whatever she wants. Last time we went to a car parts shop and rolled tires around as we were freeing the rollings from Monster. So far my wife doesn't believe her when she later on grasses me up. TBH, it's the only thing pre-COVID I miss doing. This brought back so many good memories of my dad. Thank you. Dad was putting new roof shingles on. I was probably 3, maybe 4. I asked if I could help. He said if I could climb the ladder, sure. I was always climbing so that was no issue. Climbed right on up and started handing him shingles. It would have been a don't tell your mother moment had she not come home from grocery shopping. After several back and forth of where are you and up here mom, she figured it out and flipped out. What is he doing on the roof? I'm not a dad, so I posted on behalf of my dad. My dad always wanted a son. I'm the last of four girls, so I was a huge tomboy. Whatever he was fixing, I was right there. My mom gave up on these things after a while. Fell off so many things because of this. I have always worked in restaurants and get home late nights. On Fridays I treat myself to takeout. Not just any takeout, the bad stuff. Cheese fries topped with gyro meat. Steak nachos with guac. Always a large, always with a big bottle of beer they sell singly. When my girls were little they would sneak down late at night and we would munch bad food and watch really bad funny movies with all the swear words in. That's really endearing. Story about my father. When I was about 6 or 7 we were really hard up for money at the time, so we cut down on all expenses, saving change, act. My mom would go out of town for work every other weekend. My dad would save up a few dollars over the weeks, take me to Waffle House for breakfast, go on a walk on the beach, then take me home and let me play the I Spy computer game on his work computer. He would always teasingly tell me not to tell mom about Waffle House. I don't think she would have been mad, but it was fun to have something just the two of us would do together. I love my dad. I took both kids out at around 13 to show them how to drive. Just in big empty parking lots or in the neighborhood, but they loved it and I enjoyed a little secret with them for a while. Username checks out. When I was in middle school I was the only one willing to go shopping groceries with my dad. He didn't want to go alone and my mom was at school studying her master's. None of my siblings wanted to go with him. We used to go to Carl's Jr., have a big breakfast, and then we went grocery shopping. Nobody knew, not even my mom, until years later. He would also let me buy any cereal I wanted. That's actually how I learned how to buy good fruit and veggies, how to order meat and fish, etc. When my siblings found out they were angry BC, they would have gone if a big breakfast was on the menu. My mom just laughed. Nowadays they sneak to have breakfast together before going grocery shopping since we're all grown up. One for my dad. My dad took me to my first MLB game. God, I miss baseball. And told me not to tell my mom. Later found out it was because the game was a good bit outside of the travel radius set in the custody agreement. They were arguing a lot more than usual at the time, so he knew mom would say no if he asked about it, but really wanted to take me to a game. Told me not to say anything so she couldn't use it against him while trying to take him to family court again. Luckily I didn't say anything and we got to keep sneaking away to games until the travel radius stopped being a thing. But dad still has the tickets too. This is simultaneously super sweet and depressing. I hope your mom is in a better frame of mind now, because I want my child to miss out, because that will hurt you is pretty sickening. My parents helped me out with rent during college. They'd send me a check every month for $800, which was honestly really nice of them. My mom usually does it, but for whatever reason my dad did it once and spelled my name wrong on the check. Like Alicia instead of Alyssa, so it wasn't just a spelling error but also changed the sound of my name a bit. Equals I didn't notice until I was at the bank in line at the teller already and I called my parents. My dad literally said the words "don't tell your mother about this" and didn't realize my mom was on the other line. To this day he says he was just distracted and in a rush. College was over a decade ago but my mom still plays the "at least I didn't forget what our daughter's name was" trump card now and then. My dad on all of our insurance paperwork as a kid put down the wrong birth year for me, so whenever we had to do anything for me medically wise there were always issues because he would have the year as like 1991 instead of 1990 and insurance wouldn't recognize me. To this day he will even say I was born in 1991 sometimes. My birth certificate says otherwise. Other than this he is an amazing dad. One night I was enjoying a small bit of ice cream after my 4-year-old daughter went to bed. She came downstairs and caught me, so I offered her a small bite, but since she was supposed to be in bed, I said don't tell mom. She assured me she wouldn't. My wife wouldn't have cared anyway, but it was a fun little game to play. After she went up to bed and I was down on the couch, she snuck into the master bedroom where mom was resting. She told mom that I had let her have some ice cream. and she was afraid of sugar bugs, so could she please brush her teeth again? My wife just laughed at me the next day. Little crap ratted me out to brush her teeth, something she doesn't like doing anyway. And here I am using Paw Patrol electric toothbrushes and toothpaste and frozen mouthwash to coax them into the bathroom before bed. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.